Hey everyone, I'm Sal Sincotta, and in this month's product spotlight, we are checking out the brand new Profoto C1 Plus. All right, everyone, so the C1, industry news, industry flop, industry excitement, industry paranoia, you name it, every emotion has gone on in the world of professional photography. So hopefully I can kind of share some insight, debunk a few things, and show you how or where or why you would ever even want something like this. So let's just jump right to it, right? The C1 is small and compact. And so look, you're getting some insight from a professional photographer. I'm a professional photographer. I use Profoto everywhere I shoot. I use the B1s, B10s, A1s. And so why do I like this, right? You might be wondering, is this for professionals? Is this for amateurs? And the answer is yes, it's for everyone. And so you just have to think about how would you use this particular light? It's not meant to replace our studio strobes. It's not meant to go outside in bright sunlight and overpower the sun. But there is a practical application for this. Look, if you're a photographer, you're traveling around with your phone wherever you are in the world, anytime, anywhere. You know it, I know it. And you know what I hate most? I take my iPhone, and now with the new iPhones, we can take apparently pictures that we can blow up to billboard size or larger. I'm being facetious, but you get my point. We travel the world, and what do we carry with us? Our iPhones. And I've always, always hated the image quality that comes. If you're in natural light, beautiful light. But if you're photographing in any kind of like tungsten light, late at night, friends, and you get that crappy flash that comes off on your iPhone camera, we all know what it looks like. And then what do photographers do? They take their iPhones out and they all turn on their flashlight, even worse light. So to act as if there's no potential need for something like this in your bag or in your kit, well, is not really being honest or genuine about it. So let's put all that to the side and really dig into this. And what makes this very, very unique, I believe, this is from my perspective, is its size, right? So where would you use this? I think you can use this when you're doing selfies, when you're doing, and I know it sounds ridiculous, right? As a professional photographer to be like, well, I want good light on my selfies, but we all do. We all want to look good. I don't know about you, but when I'm with my fiance and we're moving around left and right, right? We're always looking for that best light somewhere, okay? So we all do it. We're guilty of it. And so selfies, food photography, when you're out and you're taking pictures and you're posting them to Instagram, and maybe you don't do food photography, but social media. When I'm posting something online, I want it to look good. Now more than ever, our customers are judging us on our social media feeds. And so the social media aspect of this is what really, really got my attention on how I would use this. I don't want to bring my real camera, my DSLR, or a full frame camera with me wherever I go. I want to be able to create great images, well-lit images with my portable phone. So of course, social media, food, your blogging, even videos. When I'm doing videos and I'm in a darker room, I want to be able to have this as a fill light, okay? So some other things to keep in mind. Profoto has done a great job of producing a plethora of attachments. So we've got CTO gels, we've got a dome diffuser, which we have for their professional line, and then we've got a grid. So a lot of light control that you have. But something you may or may not know, but it produces two types of light. One is going to be a continuous light, so we can have our LED on that we're firing, and we can control color temperature on this as well, but it can also fire a bit of a strobe, and I'm not sure if that's showing up on camera. So you've got two different types of light that I believe make this very, very versatile, as well as using it with all these modifiers. So something that I think a lot of people don't quite realize is the power of the Profoto app, their camera. And so if you haven't downloaded this, I would download this right now. So the mobile app is free, but their camera is quite powerful. And a lot of people are losing sight of that because everybody's focused on the C1 here. So, you know, the app itself allows you to control white balance and tint, which I thought is a very powerful feature. Not only can you control your exposure, but you can control color temperature of the LED light. You can control the power output of your continuous light, as well as control the power output of your flash. And they've made it a very simple app to use, right? You either want a blended, more natural looking portrait, or you want something that's a little bit more dramatic. So they've even put it into terms that are quite simple to understand. And as you can see, as we're working through this, it is a very, very powerful light. I think it's up to your imagination how and where you use this. It's exciting things for the world of photography. So good luck. Get your hands on something like this. put it to the test, play with it. I'm telling you, whether you're a professional, an amateur, just getting started, a hobbyist, you are gonna love what you're seeing here, and you are gonna find unique and creative ways to up the level of any portrait, whether it's from a full frame camera or an iPhone.